Very good morning to one and all. All the students of class 9th D seem to be quite, you can say, aware, seem to be quite fresh. Those who are sitting with attentiveness, I can see Rishikesh, Divya, Bhavansh, Titiksha, and Harmeet Kaur only. Those who have switched on the video, so well done. You are attending the classes attentively. What about others? I don't know whether you're lying in the bed or enjoying your breakfast. That's your choice how you learn. Okay, we cannot mend it, but we can just request you to learn. Yes, Lisa is there. Okay, now very good morning to one and all. Now we will be starting the new chapter, Weathering the Storm in Arzama. I already sent you a message that be ready with your books. So, yes, Rishikesh, please read the quote written on the board. Unmute yourself.
Ma'am, difficulties do not come to destroy you, but they come to check how difficult are you.
How difficult you are. Okay. Divya, tell me the meaning of this quote. What do you understand?
That difficulties, they are not there to harm you or disturb you. They come to make you more powerful and more attentive. Yes. And
yes, very good. Well done. Well done, both of you. Well done, Rishikesh, for reading it for us. And well done, Divya, to explaining the exact meaning. Yes, difficulties do not come to destroy you. They come to check how difficult you are. So this is, I guess, one of the themes, not the whole some theme of this chapter. So this is one of the themes. That's why I chose this quote as the quote of the day for class 9th. Okay. So we always, you know, keep on cribbing in our lives that, okay, God, why you have not given us this thing? Why this difficulty is happening in my life only? Fine. So yes, Ashna, very good. Difficulties are in the form of. Okay, see, she's writing in the chat box, so I'll be reading that also. Difficulties are in the form of fear in your head, and we need to overcome it by mental toughness. Yes, very good. So the thing is, we people keep on cribbing for what we do not have and what the kind of difficulties and we are facing in our lives. Fine. Rather than concentrating on difficulties, we should, you know, see the positive side of the difficulty, that how after going through the difficulty, after facing that difficulty, you become more stronger, you come out more stronger, more powerful, and you can bear any other difficulty with more confidence. Yes, if I can do this, I can do that also. So difficult times actually make us more stronger. Fine. So this is one of the themes. Now you can see what I have written on the board. Weathering the, after this quote, Weathering the Storm in Arzama. This is the name of the chapter. Account of the storm that hit the coastal town of Arzama in Odisha state in 1999. So actually this chapter will be, you can say, an incident which occurred in 1999. Fine. It happened in 1999 in the state of Odisha. Fine. In Arzama. So Odisha lies in Arzama. So they are telling us these are the name of the places only. Fine. So in Arzama, what happened? Coastal town is there, that coastal area, that you know that the some states are always at the verge of destruction or natural calamities. What are natural calamities? Earthquake is a natural calamity. Fine. Drought. Drought means sukha pad jana, means no rain. Drought is also natural calamity. Then what else, which I have not named? Anybody can name any other natural calamity? Storms. Fine. Storms. Tufaan aa jaate hain jab. That is also one of the natural calamity. Fine. So such kind of things, sometimes water overflows. Then we have cyclones. Fine. So many kind of natural calamities are there. Then we, when we go to, you can say, Himachal side, then also any natural calamity can occur. Mountain sliding, sometimes you might have heard. Fine. So anything can come. These all come under the natural calamities. So landslides. Yes, Aryan, well done. So landslides are very common thing over there. So many things are there. But now we are going to talk about which... the natural calamity, storm. Fine. I discussed n number of natural calamities with you all, but I'm going to discuss storm. Clear? In this chapter, the main character, the protagonist, is a young boy, Prashant. His name is Prashant, and he's going to eyewitness stormy weather, and he will be stuck there in the storm. He will be visiting one of his friends, and he was not even at his own village. So he was at his friend's house, and then that happened to him. And how he comes back out of it, how he handled that difficulties, not only he saved his life, and how he saved and he tries to save the lives of the others, even losing his own loved ones. You know, people, they get broken when they lose their near and dear ones, their family members. They are not into the right mental state. But there are very few people who are very mentally, very strong, mentally, very tough. Those who have lost their dear ones, he saw, you know, he will be seeing dead bodies floating in the water. He will be seeing such kind of scenes which a common man will not be able to, you know, digest. What happened to that person? What happened to, I'm not able to even see this. So he will not be only he will be seeing to it, he will be coming out stronger out of this difficulty, fine? So this is what we are going to read in this chapter, fine? So next is, he inspires us to have courage and positive approach towards life. A young boy, Prashant, he faced the fury of the storm, and how he inspires us to have courage and positive attitude towards life. So this is what we are going to learn, fine? So this is very inspirational story. A young boy who's going to teach us that what sort of attitude is required in life. So let me share the screen with you all. Let me see. I just wait. Weathering the storm. You are having the books with you? If I won't be able to, I'm trying because the network is too slow here. Maybe I won't be able to open it. It's just wait for a while. It's not opening. Wait. So you have the books with you? Wait. Okay, fine. So now I'll be just discussing. You open your books, okay? So I'll be explaining you the chapter, and please note down some meanings. I'm not able to share the screen. Some technical fault is there. It was there in the last periods. I did share the screen, but not now. It's not possible. So on 27th October 1999, 7 years after, the death of his mother, you can see the way in the beginning we'll get to know that Prashant is not having his mother. So already 7 years ago, his mother died, fine. So already the child has suffered a lot in life, you can see, fine. Already he's tough enough. So he was raised without his mother. Prashant had gone to the block headquarters of Erzama, a small town in coastal Odisha, some 18 kilometers from his village, to spend the day with a friend. So this is in the beginning of the chapter, what happens that Prashant, sometimes, you people decide that I will be visiting my friend's house, and then we will be staying together for a night stay karte hain, and we will have, we will watch movies, and we will eat popcorns, and we will relish that time. Sometimes we spend time with our friends. So that kind of thing, because Prashant was raised without mother. So already he was having tough life. So what happens is, he had gone to the block headquarters of Erzama, a small town in coastal Odisha. Coastal is the near to the sea, fine? That's why it is called coastal area. So coastal Odisha wali site pe tha wo, and it was some 18 kilometers. You can very well imagine 18 kilometers is a long distance. So he was 18 kilometers away from his own village, and he wanted to spend the day with his friend. So he thought that in the morning I will be reaching there, and in the evening I will what will happen that after spending the time, I will come back. And a dark and menacing storm quickly gathered. Winds beat against the houses with a speed and fury that Prashant had never witnessed before. But he never imagined what will happen. So when he was returning back, what happened? That a lot of, you can say, quick change in the weather was there. Stormy weather and winds beat against the houses with a speed and fury that Prashant had never ever witnessed before in his life, right? So that was the problem. Okay, now I'm so for a while it was like muted. Now let's continue. I will be making you write some word meanings, and please note down the word of menacing in the very beginning, because I'm not having the book with me and share screen option is not there right now. It's not working. So please note down some words over there. Menacing is there. Menacing means dangerous and harmful. So please note down if you have books on the book itself or in the notebook, okay? Menacing means dangerous and harmful. The next word is fury, F-U-R-Y. Fury means, वैसे तो fury is anger, fine? But here it means extreme strength. Extreme strength. In this context, the meaning of fury is extreme strength. Incessant, next word is incessant. Incessant means continuous, without stopping. Incessant means continuous, without a stop. Then next word is ancient. Ancient means old. Ancient means old. Then next is swirled. Swirled means moved along with a whirling motion. Swirling motion, you swirl ka option hota na, PPT making mein bhi hota hai. Swirling means moving and whirling along with the whirling motion, you can write. Whirling motion, W-H-I-R-L-I-N-G, whirling motion, okay? So then we have mortar. Mortar is the next word, M-O-R-T-A-R. Mortar means... mortar is actually, you know, mixture of, you might have seen the, when buildings are being made, the mix of cement, sand, water, fine, which is used to construct buildings. So cement, they mix with water. So mortar is that, a mixture of lime, a mixture of cement, water, sand, etc. Excuse me. Clear? So these are the words which come in the beginning of the chapter. Clear? So what happened over there? Prashant had never witnessed before. Heavy and incessant rain was there when he was returning. So now some students are joining, you know, when we have already done the half part. Very bad this is. So heavy and incessant rain filled the darkness and ancient trees were uprooted. The level of the storm was that trees got uprooted. Now you very well imagine what will be the condition of Prashant at that time. So trees getting uprooted, screams rent the air, you know, shouting of the people could be heard, screaming of the people could be heard. Angry waters swirled into his friend's house also. So he was at his friend's house at that time. Very fast wind was blowing. So velocity of the wind, the speed of the wind was 350 kilometer per hour. You can underline this also. 350 kilometer per hour. So velocity of the wind was quite fast, and but the, you know, cold terror of the family grew with the, everybody was terrorized. Every person in the village was terrorized. Even the family of Prashant's friend, where he was residing, where he had gone to visit them, they were also terrorized, you know. Sometime in the middle of the night, it was damaging the roofs and walls and loud noises. So everybody was terrorized. So that cold terror was there, and crashing of the trees, and they were falling, you know, one of the trees got uprooted. And hawa mein, you can imagine that tree hawa mein ud rahe. So it got uprooted and it fell on the roof of his friend's house. So you can imagine the velocity of the wind. So that was the terrible scene. Fine. So Prashant was a native of a village in coastal state of Odisha. And then that happened. And there was, you know, when water started flowing inside the house. And it was like, you know, neck deep water. Neck deep water means the person is about to drown into it. So that neck deep water entered into the house of his friend. And but the good thing was that his friend's house was a pakka house. Clear? So you might have heard about the concepts of kacha houses and pakka houses, you know. So made up of mortar, made up of cement. So it was made up of bricks, cement, and that quite strong building. So because that house was a pakka house, so they were saved. So they could go to stairs up and they could, you know, save their lives. So water entered into the house of his friend. He was also terrorized. The family was terrorized. And it was in the middle of the night. Trees had fallen on the house, you know, damaging the roof, damaging the walls of the building. And how he reaches over there next morning, we will be reading that in the next part. Okay, that how you can see in the picture, if any picture is given in the book. Fine. There was neck deep water, and the crazy destruction, you know, it was now wrought up by the cyclone. So that cyclone means whirling wind. Water was also you can say flood kind of situation, stormy weather, cyclones, and the surge of ocean continued for the next 36 hours. So it was not going to stop within 2 hours or 3 hours. When cyclones do occur, when stormy weather was there, it was for many hours. So it was going to continue for next 36 hours. So you can imagine what will be the condition. Clear? Wind speeds reduced, no doubt. The speed of the wind reduced. But by the next morning, you can say, but to escape the waters rising in the house, that could not be saved. So Prashant and his friend's family, they decided to take refuge on the roof of his house. So he was stuck at his friend's house only. He thought that in the evening he would come back, but he was not able to. He was not able to come back. So he, along with his friend's family, they went to rooftop, and then they will never forget this scene. What they eyewitnessed from the, because when they were inside the house, they were not able to see the destruction from their own eyes. So they have to shift because water level was surging higher and higher. They decided to go to the rooftop. And when they reached there, Prashant and his friend's family, they had taken refuge on the roof. Prashant was shocked to see, he saw the devastation, the destruction with his eyes, which was brought by this super cyclone. This was not a cyclone only, that was a super cyclone, because when trees get uprooted, when everything was whirling and heavier objects were also getting whirled into the cyclone, so that was a super cyclone. And he could see the gray light of the early morning. So it was the early morning time, dawn time, D-A-W-N, when they decided to go up there. Fine, please write down the word meanings now, three more words. Four more words. Refuge means to take shelter. Refuge means, if you're not able to find the word, then please note down anywhere. Refuge means to take shelter. Rot, w-r-o-g-h-t. Next word is rot, w-r-o-u-g-h-t. Rot means produced as a result of something. Produced as a result of something. Yeah, so the storm continued for the next 1.5 day, although the wind had slowed down. So to escape the rising levels of water, they shifted there. But in the day, when the day dawned, he saw the destruction and he was not aware inside the house ki itni zyada destruction hui thi. And he was stuck over there. He was thinking about his own village, how he will move there, what will happen next. Fine, a raging deadly brown sheet of water covered everything as far as the eye could see. So as far as his eyes could approach, he could see the only fractured cemented houses, broken things, bloated animal carcasses. What do you mean by carcass? Underline. Carcass means dead bodies of the animals. Carcass means dead bodies of the animals. We do not use the word carcass for dead bodies of the human beings, okay? We use the word carcass for the dead bodies of animals only. Fine. For the dead bodies of human beings, we use the word corpse, corpse. Corpse. It is written over there. You can underline. Human corpses floated in every direction. Carcasses of animals could be seen, like cows and whatever kind of animals are found in the villages. They were there. And then human corpses were there in each and every direction. What else was there? Even huge old trees had fallen. And then two coconut trees had fallen on the roof of their house. This was a blessing, actually. Sometimes something bad happens, but actually, there is good in that. So they were stuck on the rooftop. They could not go down and they could not eat anything. They were hungry also. So by God's grace, coconut trees fell on the roof of his friend's house. So they could eat coconuts and they were able to survive. That's why. So, the tender coconuts from the trees kept the trapped family from starving. So they were starving. Starving means bhook se marna, So they were already starving and they were hungry. They wanted to eat something and they could not eat anything. They could not go downstairs. So they got this blessing that coconut tree fell only. And this is in abundance, found in, you go to south side in Odisha and all. It is easily in abundance, coconut trees. So several days. They were able to have those, fine. So, what do you mean by fractured? Fractured means broken. Kehte na, I'm fracture ho gaya in that they have used this word fractured for trees also. Fractured means broken. Bloated word. Next word is bloated. BLOATED. Bloated means swollen. Please note down the word meanings. You can write down at a separate place. You can find out later on. Fractured means broken. Bloated means swollen, SWOLLEN. Then animal carcasses means dead bodies of animals. Tender means soft. Tender coconuts, they have used the word na, soft. Tender means soft. Then blessing in disguise. Blessing in disguise means actually that misfortune which leads to good results. It was a misfortune that a tree fell on the top, but that misfortune turned into a blessing that they got coconuts to eat. So blessing in disguise, fine. Chupa hua blessing tha ye unke liye. Fine. So they could just see the brown, muddy, smelly, you can stinky water all around where dead bodies could be seen, where remains of the houses could be seen. Fine, very, you can say, a heart-wrenching scene one could see that it's not worth watching, that you won't be able to, watch such kind of scene. So that he saw and his family also eyewitnessed, but he's still stuck at the house of his friend. So I won't be continuing the rest of part. Because we are left with only, I guess, 2 minutes. Yes, till 12 we have, na? 12, from 12 to 12:15 you have break. So tell me if it is clear to you all, please send me thumbs up. If any doubt is there, you can ask me. So almost all are saying that it's clear. Okay, Titiksha, you have a doubt?